to Barkov, and he becomes the first ever Bay Area-born player to play for the San Jose Sharks and play in goal for the San Jose Sharks. We are underway, flicking it back for Mikhail Granlund, who leads the Sharks in power play scoring this year with 17 points, 16 of them assists for the veteran Granlund. Loved down by Addison. And a nice feed for Zetterlund, and they score! Yes, they score! Thomas Bortolo on the redirect, and it's 1-0 Sharks.
Right here, kind of pops off his stick, but they come down and support it. Granlund, and then that play over in the air, catch, and then a quick shot to the front, and that little redirect. What a play by Zetterlund. Look, he choked up on his stick, so he could capture that little pass in tight on his body. And you can see that redirect beautifully located by Bortolo up and over Mrazek's shoulder.
Burrows, and now Barabanov once more walks it out, takes it to the net. Down is Mrazek. Puck is loose, still available. Mrazek can't find it. He's won three in a row against them and seven of his last eight starts against the Sharks.
Two great stops by Mrazek here to really settle it down for the Blackhawks, and it could have easily been 3-0 here.
Here's Bortolo again, and he scores again! Thomas Bortolo, two in the first period, and it's 2-0 Sharks.
Really nice angle here that I had on this shot. Again, getting that puck, that 50-50 battle there, and you can see Bortolo picks it up on the backhand. That puck was rolling when he picked it up. And I had a perfect angle at this as he grabs it, gets it to the forehand. No other stick handling. It came to the forehand and he releases it against the grain on Mrazek. That was just a well-placed shot.
But it stays in to Jones. Now Bedard, he'll look. Play it to the net off the goalpost. Cooley may have gotten a piece. Here comes Entwistle for Chicago with Reichel. Reichel across, shot by Slaggard, and a stick save for Devin Cooley. Now Cunning tracking back to center, strips it away from Athanasiou. They collide right in front of you at the Chicago bench, Brett. And now the gloves come off, and Cunning and Athanasiou are going to slug it out.
Yeah, this is a play, and Athanasiou came at him and hit him in an awkward way, and Cunning said, let's go.
Feel the energy in the Shark Tank tonight.
Well, here's the play in the neutral zone. Happy to see you on his back, and he just won that little battle. There's that kind of slew foot in on Cunning, and that's when he came up and said, let's go.
So five each for fighting to those two. And we'll stay at 5-on-5. Matt Tennyson also came up through the Junior Sharks program and played for the Sharks, but he was Minnesota-born. Devin's from Los Gatos, and you could tell his family couldn't be prouder to be here. Very special night indeed, and hopefully in a couple of hours from now, they'll be celebrating Devin's first NHL victory. We shall see. A good start, and a good start to this period as Fabian Zetterlund makes it 3-0.
Streaking down the middle. And you can see Carlson right over on that right, and that pass into an area, and another catch and release, this one off the leg of Vlasic, the defenseman for Chicago, and then redirects the other angle. That's why Mrazek really didn't even move on the play.
His shot is blocked, and here's Connor Bedard. He'll pull back and get a shot away. Cooley a save, and then another off Connor Bedard.
Took that into the boards.
Well, the Sharks can make Chicago pay for that hit right here. And they do! And it's Zetterlund! And it's 4-0! That's 20 for Fabian Zetterlund!
But watch this no-look pass right there by William Eklund, right on the tape on the doorstep. No chance for Mrazek because of that look from Eklund. And this is just a world-class pass right there on the back door. That lovely little look one way, throwing back the other.
Bortolo twice, and then 2:24 for Zetterlund. And a great save by Cooley, and another off Connor Bedard.
And this is just a two-on-one down low. Vlasic holding tight, but what a pass by Foligno. That's another nice stop by Mrazek. He's led in four tonight, but he's played really well.
Sharks already with 21 shots in this game. They're not quite halfway into it. There's a goal for Chicago on the rebound. It's Ryan Donato, and they break through to make it 4-1.
This is just a real simple entry. You've got plenty of players back for the Sharks. Shot comes in, and that rebound right there. Addison just not able to control the stick from Donato. He's able to get a little piece of that and sneaks it in the short side on Cooley. But
Fox fought back from 2-0 down against the Sharks Sunday night at the United Center. Ended up winning 5-2. Penalty coming up here to Granlin. Donato in front, and the Hawks score. Tyler Johnson puts it away, and it's 4-2.
And finds Johnson. There's the little reverse. There's the play where Donato engages with Granlin, and then the penalty was going to be called. And then Donato gets up and makes a strike of a pass. And then what a shot by Johnson, the veteran. He just gets this, and they get Donato some credit there. Gets up off that after being knocked down and makes the play on a perfect pass to Johnson right through that stick of Addison. And then going up and over the glove, top corner.
All-time meeting between the Sharks and Chicago Blackhawks. Fabian Zetterlin with two goals. Eric Bedard was hooked by Costin. Up goes Mrazek. Some bonus time here for the Hawks power play. Kaiser to Jones. Jones shot and he scores. Seth Jones, and Chicago makes it 4-3.
Goaltender out, the extra attacker hits him with the puck, reverses it out to the defenseman, his partner, and gets it back. And now he's got some time here, and he's got Foligno parked right in front of him. And you can see Jones just kind of taking advantage of that distraction and finds a hole. And now it's just a one goal hockey game.
Fifth goal and left in the third. Here's a chance in front for Lowe, and what a save! Peter Mrazek!
They've needed a stop. He's been the guy. And what a play. Bailey just in between. Look at the hands of Bortolo. Pull it on the backhand, and the glove stop.
Donato all the way around. Here's Seth Jones. Jones into the corner for Foligno. Behind the net, Donato. Out to the side. Puck is there. They score! The Blackhawks tie it with 47 seconds left. It's 4-4.
And behind the net, Donato's going to get this set up again. They do the cycle. Here's Donato with the puck. And throws on one side of the net where he probably should have been on the other. They should have both had a post. And this is where Kurashev just has that opportunity. And right there, he sticks with it. Not once, but twice.
We'll just play for overtime now. As Kurashev, as I said rather, has it behind the Chicago net. And that'll do it for regulation. We're going to 3-on-3 overtime. And we're set for 3-on-3 overtime here in San Jose. Chicago starts with the puck. And Seth Jones now. Kurashev. They'll bring it across the line. Looking for Bedard, who cuts to the net. Jones with the puck. Takes the shot and scores. Seth Jones wins the game in overtime. 5-4, the final for Chicago. What a comeback.
And Cooley now's done. This is Kurashev cutting across. And he just does a nice little pass as he finally gets his head up, makes the pass into Jones. Brower trying to come out and at least present some force into Jones, but he pulls it onto that forehand and just lets a good wrist shot go and beats Cooley over the glove for the winner. But Kurashev, nice cut back, and give Jones credit here. It comes in, and Brower just has to respect him And that shot goes by for the winner.